Hello, my name is Thomas Dimitrovich. During this session, we'll speak to leveraging fuses and circuit breakers when selectively coordinating around a transformer. The example that we'll use is a 30 kVA transformer with a 480 volt line-to-line primary voltage and a 208 volt line-to-line secondary voltage. We are only going to select the primary fuse for this application. This solution will work with any downstream circuit breaker panel solution that selectively coordinates to the maximum available short circuit current on the secondary of this transformer. The primary full load amps of the transformer is needed to determine the maximum size fuse for transformer primary protection. The primary full load amps is calculated as 36.08 amps at 480 volts. We use table 450.3b of the National Electrical Code to determine the maximum fuse size for the primary main fuse F6. The maximum size of the primary fuse is calculated by multiplying 36.08 amps by 2.5. 90 amps is our maximum fuse size. The next calculation we need to make is the short circuit current on the primary. To get this number, we'll calculate the secondary infinite bus short circuit current and reflect that to the primary. Putting our math to work for infinite bus short circuit current calculations, we calculate 2,081.79 amps on the secondary. We'll round that up to 2,082 amps. This is based on a 30 kVA transformer with 4% impedance. If you change any of those two parameters, the numbers will be different. We're approaching this as a worst case scenario, as we don't want to have to make changes after the fact. To obtain the current that the primary fuse will see during a short circuit event on the secondary, which is calculated to be 2,082 amps, we have to reflect the 2,082 amps to the primary based on the turns ratio of the transformer. To calculate that current, I multiply 2,082 amps by 208 secondary volts divided by 480 primary volts. This shows us that for a 2,082 amp calculated short circuit current on the secondary, the primary current flowing during that fault will only be 902.2 amps. For our sake, we're going to round that up to 903 amps. Knowing that the primary fuse will see 903 amps during this short circuit event on the secondary, we review the time current characteristic curve for the fuse to determine selectivity with the circuit breakers on the secondary. To achieve selectivity, the TCC must show that the through short circuit current of 903 amps is less than where the fuse curve crosses 0.01 seconds. This is the trip curve for the TCF 70 amp fuse. The 903 amps of primary short circuit current is to the left of where the fuse curve crosses 0.01 seconds. This tells us that any TCF fuse 70 amps and greater will work on the primary of this transformer, regardless of the circuit breaker solution that selectively coordinates on the secondary. The TCF90 can be selected, as this is the maximum size overcurrent protective device permitted by the National Electrical Code. The fuse solution on the primary of this transformer does provide some flexibility in moving to a smaller fuse for tighter protection of this transformer below the maximum permitted by the NEC, should the engineer decide to do so. The only restriction outside of the maximum fuse size permitted by the NEC is the inrush current of the transformer. Leveraging a fuse on the primary of a transformer will require calculating through short circuit current. Leveraging the fast-acting natured fuse will help as we selectively coordinate up to the utility. This fuse solution on the primary of this transformer will achieve our goals regardless of what secondary breakers are selected. Thank you for taking the time to talk about this technical topic.